Smith to answer that question.
It's quite a simple question, because if you have a lot of wildlife on your land, if it's wild land, it has no rental value whatsoever, so you have no impact. And the more you use that land for purposes, the more rental income you have. And so therefore, it is perfectly, the person who views this mixture has to pay for that abuse. That is what land value tax is essentially telling us. So in a city where well over 95% of all the land rent is, we'll be paying that. And if you use natural resources, because we're not just talking about land as a physical space that we're upbeat, but all natural resources, you pay for what you use. So it's perfectly fair. Now, the other element of your question is something that is many people criticize land value tax, because they have some form of privilege. The privilege of owning land, the privilege of having the right to use oil. And they say, I want my privilege. My privilege is everything to me. I can't live life without my privilege. But if we all say that, we'll mess the planet up, just like we're doing. So we have to start abandoning the idea that we have a privilege to abuse nature. Nature should be shared by all, or its value should be shared by all, like land, and its abuse should be paid for. And the benefit of paying for that abuse should be shared by us all. What it's doing is a land value tax is saying, are you doing something about land when you can get the productivity from it? If you can't, it will go below the margin and come out of production. And that's why I'm interested in the land value tax. 40% of the land surface of the UK has to be subsidised to be farmed. And what is those subsidies? We're paying people to destroy wildlife. So it's about time, if we ever want to have real wildlife for land back in this country, the best way to do is tax its farm. And therefore, we could reclaim all of that land. Over the last 200 years, we've lost all of our uplands due to in lots of waste subsidies. You know, the uplands would be a completely different place if we just stopped giving people money and tax their abuses for that land. We should all have the responsibility for using land efficiently. And obviously when you put taxes on the externalities of the inputs of land and your activities, you are then getting the perfect judge of whether you truly are damaging the environment or not. That is the razor that will tell you. And if you can't pay those taxes, you won't do the crime.
That's very well put.
I've been a rewilder for 20 years. And I've met George, and I know Fred knows George very well from a long time ago in their journalist career. And what George Wongi says is exactly right. I've been trying to rewild for 20 years. I've tried, it's been my career since an academic career. Everything I've done to rewild Britain. And I've come across that the only way we can do it is to actually tax the land, because, as I said, 40% of the land, which is mostly uplands, it's the floodplains, it's the areas that are poor for humans to occupy. We're paying farmers to destroy it. And we're paying, and it's not just subsidies. Your grandmother owners get all kinds of tax breaks. Strange tax breaks of capital gains, inheritance tax. Many other tax breaks appear in land that we just don't know about. It's probably owned by a secretive trust and company in the Cayman Islands. And this is all going on, and they can get away with it, because holding onto that land has no cost. Bringing a cost to that land, getting rid of subsidies, will push that land back into wildlife land. Of course, how we use that efficiently is when you get rewilding, because rewilding, having the beaver, having the wild horses, having the wolves wandering, even having bears in certain parts of the country, will allow that land to be managed in the way that will produce the most biodiversity and stop us flooding all the other ecosystem services that were delivered by nature. It will absorb carbon. The amount of carbon that's released by land is phenomenal, probably more than what we're pumping into the air through fossil fuels. We bring back rewilding, we'll sequestrate a lot of that carbon. So the land value tax is the way every landowner from a wildlife destroyer where he gets paid and gets benefits by destroying nature into a wildlife conserver, because every time he hurts wildlife, it's going to come out of his pocket. And that is what a landowner.